They say that we start on Monday, but the strong start on Sunday. Won't be in bondage to any man. John 8:33. We the descendants of Abraham. Yea, you should be made free. John 8:36. To whom the Son set free is free indeed. He say the wretch like me.
Welcome to the Big Little Sports Review Show. Today we are going to talk about all the good games from this weekend. We're also going to cover some breaking news that we're going to talk about.
The bad games too.
And the bad games too. and we're going to give our opinions on all the games.
So the first game we're going to talk about is actually with the local game that we watched, the Triumph versus Toronto FC. That was a pretty fun game, right?
Yeah. Well, at least for the Triumph.
Yeah. So they ended up being scored. The final score was 3-0, and actually
or
two.
Or as it would actually be called in soccer, 3-0.
Yeah. Sorry about that. 3-0. All you soccer fans out there. Instead of say football. Anyways. So, but one of the scores was really the first two scores was like the first 5 minutes.
Yeah.
So that was pretty quick. But the second score was really cool. Like it was actually like a kick all the way almost from midfield. The Toronto FC kind of tipped it, and it went right to the Triumph player, and he kicked it right in. So we got a little clip of it, so we're going to go ahead and show it to you. So check this out, a little quick one here. You see, like, Triumph guy tried to kick it all the way down. And, oh no, right to Triumph. Oh, goal, goal! So that was the second score. That was a pretty sweet goal, right?
Yeah.
And so basically Triumph pretty much dominated that game, but coming into that game they were on a 4-game losing streak.
And before that they only had two draws,
yeah. So they hadn't won in 6 games. So they went right here on this game this weekend, they went 3-0, so they're still in the 3-seed now. So they're still in a position to make the playoffs.
Yeah.
You know, and they are actually the champions from last year in the USL League One. So let's see if they can do it again. And then let's get to college football. The first full length of college football games. And one of the pretty awesome games we watched was the UNC Virginia Tech game.
I would say it was a big upset for Virginia Tech, considering that they weren't even ranked in the power rankings.
Yeah.
UNC was actually ranked pretty high, number 9.
Yeah, I think they were 10. They were 10, right?
I think they were 9.
9 or 10. It might have been 9 in one of the polls and 10 in another one. The point is, they were predicted to have a big season this year after what they did last year, but they lost a couple players on offense. And actually, Virginia Tech played an awesome defense. Their defense was—they were all over Howell the whole game. They ended up sacking him 6 times.
In the victory.
Yeah, and he ended up throwing 3 interceptions. The last of it, which was pretty much decided the game with them down 17-10. They had a chance to drive and get the tying score. But he was almost about to get sacked again, and then in the middle just kind of threw it. So we got that clip for you too. So you can see what happens here. All right, here we go. This is the pretty much the last play for UNC of the game.
Well, had to have been.
It doesn't want to play now.
It's loading.
Never mind.
Intermission.
Oh, here we go. Okay. Da-da-da. So here you go. You can see how it's gonna roll out. Oh, here comes the Tech players. Oh, he's got him. Oh, he's going down. Oh, I'm just gonna throw it. Oh, to the other team. No, game over. Interception. It actually, you can see at the end there, he kind of bobbled the ball, but after the review, he caught it. And then when he gets down, he had possession, and he was trying to get back up to celebrate is when he dropped the ball, so it didn't matter. Game over. They win. Do you have any other thoughts on that game, Sebastian?
Honestly, it was pretty close at the end of the game, but in the first half, it wasn't even close. Like, Virginia Tech was leading 14-0.
Yeah, they jumped on them quick. That was like in the first quarter, I think. And then from then on, it was a pretty slow game. So from there, yeah, it was only 13 more points scored. What other game were we going to
cover? Next, we're going to go to the Penn State-Wisconsin game.
Oh, yeah, that was a great game.
Wisconsin fumbled the ball once in the end zone and then almost fumbled the game away. But then on that same drive, the Wisconsin quarterback threw a pick when they could have got the lead and won 17-16.
Yeah, what Sebastian was talking about was it was 16-10 at the time, right?
Yes.
And Wisconsin was driving down to score the go-ahead touchdown. And even before they even got to that, on first down, they actually fumbled the ball. Remember, their quarterback fumbled the ball,
yeah.
But luckily they were able to get back on it. But then 3 plays later on 4th and goal, he threw an interception. And we thought that was pretty much it. And it turns out they got another chance.
But then threw another interception.
In the red zone. So that pretty much sealed the deal for that. So that Penn State had a pretty big victory on that one. We're going to take a break from talking about the games now. We're going
to get some breaking news.
Dun-dun-dun, breaking news. What do you got for our first breaking news, buddy?
For our first subject, we have 4 teams applying for the Big 12. This will be a smart decision for the Big 12 if they accept all of them, because they only have 10 teams right now. If they're going to lose 2, and they didn't accept any of them, they would become the Big 8.
Yeah, they have to change the name to the Big 8, right?
But with these 4 teams, once Texas and Oklahoma leave, they'll be the Big 12 again.
Yep. I'm hoping for, as a Liberty fan, but those 3 of those 4 teams leaving the American Athletic Conference, that I'm hoping maybe Liberty will try to get into the American Athletic. That would be cool, right?
Yeah, they've never been in a conference.
Nope, not since leaving the Big South and the FCS. What's our second one? We got Cam Newton. Cam Newton was released by the Patriots. That was a shocker to a lot of people, right?
Well, let's make it sound more dramatic.
Okay.
Cam Newton was cut.
He was cut.
By the Patriots.
Oh, man. Yeah, that was surprising. Cam Newton, you can see how a player gets derailed his career by just injuries, right? Like, Cam Newton was on top of the world like 5 years ago. 15-1, had the Panthers into the Super Bowl, was NFL MVP, and now he, you know, is just fighting to even make a team. What's our last breaking news we got is the...
The USL already has 2 leagues, but now is adding a third league to the USL family, the USLW.
Yeah, we have a women's league, so that's pretty cool.
That's coming out at the end of this season.
Yeah, and for you all that don't know, the USL is actually the league where Greenville Try and Play, so they're adding a women's league. All right, so let's get back into the games. We got UM and Alabama. Whew, that was a rough one.
Alabama got destroyed the Hurricanes.
Yeah. Oh, who's that? Oh, it's the Hurricanes getting pummeled by the Elephants, the Crimson Tide.
Well, I guess Alabama scored another touchdown.
Yeah, I think they pretty much destroyed them on that one.
The final score in that game was 44-13.
Yeah, Miami never even... Unfortunately for us Hurricane fans, it was maybe 5 minutes of joy before the game was out of hand, right? So Miami pretty much... The crazy thing about it is that Miami returned 19 of 22 starters for this game from last year. And Alabama, they lost 6 first-round players. You would have thought Miami would have had some kind of a chance, but obviously not. So maybe in another 20 years we'll win a championship.
We haven't been able to win it since the Big East.
Yep, since they were in the Big East.
In 2001.
No. And then there was the game of the night, or the game of the week, billed as the two heavyweight champ or the top five matchup, the Georgia and Clemson.
The final score in that one was 10-3, and the deciding score was actually on defense, where Georgia intercepted the Clemson quarterback for a 74-yard touchdown. Yes. And we have a clip of that.
Yeah, let's take a look at that.
You just closed it.
Did I close it?
Yes, you did.
All right.
Well,
46 seconds in. All right, well. Okay.
No,
still do it. Still do it. Just find it.
I can't find it.
Go.
I don't know how to find it.
Let me do it.
No, buddy, we can't.
Sebastian.
No.
It's cut.
Yeah, that was. I thought I clicked on it when we just. So, well, you guys are going to have to see for yourselves.
Google it.
Google it. Clemson, Georgia, what was it, 74-yard touchdown?
Yes, 74-yard.
So, that was in, like, the first or second quarter?
Second quarter.
So, the game was a defensive game, obviously. 10-3 was the final. And
we actually have two fun facts about this game. So, the first one, this is Clemson's first game in 136 games where they are shut down in the first half.
They were shut out. Yeah, they were shut out in the first half. Clemson.
Yes. They didn't score until the fourth quarter.
Yeah, that was
And cool. Another fun fact, this is the lowest scoring top five matchup since 1950.
I don't think any of us in this room were born at that point.
None of us.
I don't even think our grandparents were born. Were our grandparents born?
Her grandparents, yes. Not his.
What else we got, buddy? What was some other games that we found interesting this weekend?
Well, we also saw the UCLA beat LSU, and now UCLA is off to a 2-0 start.
Yeah, and what the other big thing about that, who was your Pac-12 champion pick this year?
UCLA.
That was his bold prediction, and it's looking pretty good right now.
Yeah, now it's not really that much of a bold prediction.
Well, it's still a lot of games to be played, but so far they are looking well. So Chip Kelly, who was on the UCLA coach, was on the hot seat coming into this year, and he's doing pretty well in it.
The final score was UCLA 38, LSU 27.
All right, and so what else? What are we gonna get into next?
Next, we're gonna go into our honorable mention.
So these are games that we didn't necessarily watch, but
the whole game.
Yeah, we saw some of the bits or the highlights and some shockers, you know, per se.
The first one I'd like to mention is Presbyterian scoring 84 points in a single game versus St. Andrews.
Yeah, that was...
The quarterback threw 10 touchdowns.
Yeah, 10 touchdowns with 538 yards. So I don't care who you are, if you're in FCS, FBS, Division 1, Division 2, Division 8, it doesn't...
There is no such thing.
I know there isn't. I'm just saying there. If you throw 10 touchdown passes, that is an amazing accomplishment. So that's already, that was pretty crazy. What was the other one? The other big blowout that we saw?
Another big blowout was Idaho State being...
Simon Fraser.
Beating Simon Fraser by a score of 68-0.
Yeah, I feel sorry for Simon. Oh my goodness, can you imagine he's getting hammered the whole game like that? Down. He's beat down the whole game. What else do we have? Oh, the OU Tulane game. Oklahoma was actually up
37-14, yeah, but they only scored 3 points, in the second half.
Those 3 points helped them somehow maintain the game, and they end up winning 40 to 35.
Well, Tulane was actually just 1 yard short. 1 yard.
Of a first down, though.
Of a first down on a fourth
down
conversion.
They could have kept the drive going and possibly took over.
But the quarterback did the flip at the wrong time.
Yeah, well, he was somewhat like a player or something swiped at his feet and got kind of tipped and went down. What else we got? Oh, another local team, Furman. They won 29-18 over NCA&T. Star of the game there was Furman's starting quarterback, Hamp Session. He threw for 362 yards and 3 touchdowns. Not bad. He had a pretty good game.
Yeah. In fact, that was 3 yards less than one of NFL's quarterbacks' highest passing yards game. Brett Favre or what?
Brett Favre.
He threw for 365 yards. The other quarterback threw for 362 yards.
That's crazy. And then one we didn't watch until we saw the highlights the next day, and remember the big comeback from UCF.
Yeah.
They were down
21-0
to Boise State. Yep, and it came all the way back for the win. So that's pretty tough to do. Usually about 14 points is not difficult to come back, but when you're down 21, that's when it starts getting pretty tough. That's three. You got to score 4 times and shut them down 3 times. You know, that's tough. And then of course it wouldn't be a honorable mention without our beloved Liberty Flames.
They beat Campbell's Fighting Camels. Yes, that's their real... The
Campbell
Camels.
Fighting Camels. Try to say that real quick. Say it really fast.
The Campbell Fighting Camels. The Campbell Fighting Camels.
Actually, you can say it better, faster. But Malik Willis, the star quarterback, he had a decent game. I mean, he didn't even play the fourth quarter. They sat him down. After the third quarter, he had 212 passing yards, a touchdown, 55 yards rushing, and another touchdown. So he managed the game well, and they came out with a victory.
47-7.
So what's our last game of the night that we...
Notre Dame versus Florida State University. Florida State in overtime missed a field goal. And
yes. For the quarterback.
Yeah, the quarterback, McKenzie Milton, I think his name is. He, you guys might remember him from UCF. He played for UCF when they proclaimed themselves the national champions when they went undefeated and beat Auburn in the, I believe it was the Fiesta Bowl, maybe, or Cotton Bowl, I can't remember. But in the following season, they were going undefeated again, and he got hurt towards the end of the year, like one of the worst knee injuries ever, and he was out of football for 2 years, ended up transferring to Florida State, and almost led them to a victory. Florida State was actually down 18 at one point.
And they still brought it to overtime.
Yeah, it came back. The only thing I found interesting about that game was I was wondering why they pulled Jordan, their other starting quarterback. What was it? Travis Jordan, I think his name is. He had actually just scored a touchdown the drive before the drive that Milton took over. I thought maybe he got hurt. That was a great game.
Thank you for watching our show for today. Keep an eye out for our next episode coming on Wednesday, the NFL preview show.
And thanks to ESPN, we were able to show you some replays of the games on our TV here.
And USL.
And USL, sorry, and USL. USF and ESPN. Okay, that's it for today. That's the big
little sports review show.
Bye, y'all.
If you woke and wake up with Judas kissing makeup, even with the bitter cup, forgave my brothers a drink up, did everything but gave up, stabbed my back, I came front, still we win, we prayed up, even when we die, we raise up, ain't no wanting, no we need it, the powers that be have been greedy. We need ours by this evening. No white flag or no treaty. We got the product. We got the tools. We got the minds. We got the youth. We
going wild, we on the loose. People is lying, we are the truth. Everything old should now become new. The leaves will be green, bearing the fruit. Love God and our neighbor as written in Luke. The army of God and we are the truth.